In this video, I'm going to show you how to create this style by using CapCut. This style usually used for a music video and documentary style like Magnates Media and Wax Media. For this style, you need a lot of images and a video. For the images, you can find them on Unsplash and the Pixels website. Both of them are great and free. Now, let's jump into the CapCut. So first, we need to import our image into the timeline. So select all of them like this. I imported into the timeline. Since we want the fast passes style, we need to reduce the duration to 2 or 3 frames. You can go with 1 frame too, but I think 2 or 3 frames is better. But you need more images, so let's reduce duration to 2 frames. So put your playhead at the frame 3, so we can go on frame 3 by using arrow keys on your keyboard. And you can see it from here, our playhead is on the frame 3. Then press W and make sure your magnet key is on the timeline, because it's gonna stick other layer to this layer, so we don't need to do it manually. So put your playhead at the frame 6 and hit enter, then go for 9, you can see it from here, and press W and continue like this for all the images. If I play the video, you can see it. Yeah, it's very good. And let's import this beard image into the timeline too. So go 3 frames further and press W. And let's use this one too. So now we should duplicate them. You can use more image into your timeline, but I want to duplicate them, it's fine for me. So select all of them and hold the Alt and move them to the right side. You can randomize them again and put some of them here and between these frames to get some random image. So if I play the video, you can see. Now select all the layers and scale them a little like this. Now import your video into the timeline. You can use the vertical or horizontal size, it depends on you. I just use this video in the Pixel website. I think 10 seconds is good, so I cut this frame here, or maybe 8 seconds. Now for remove a person into the shot, you think I'm gonna use a removing background feature, but no. CapCut dropped a new feature last month, the brush option in the mask tool. So let me show you how you can use it. Select your video layer and on the right side, click on a mask tab. At the mask, select the brush. From here, you can choose the brush size. Make sure you select the quick brush. Then adjust the size of your brush. Then start to draw on a person like this. The cool part is, even if your subject is moving, CapCut can track it automatically. It's similar to the After Effects and it's very cool. So if I play the video, you can see everything is fine here. Yeah. Now you should invert it. So click on this icon here. We invert the mask. So now we can see the image inside the person and it's very cool, but we are not done yet. So select all the images and duplicate them again and put them here and duplicate them again. We need it for 10 or 8 seconds. Duplicate it again. Now select all the images and right click on it and create a compound clip. We need to, let's cut this part. Now we need to remove the background, this yellow background. So how we can do it? We are not gonna use the remove background option. We need to select all the layers, the video and the images, and right click on it and create another compound clip. Then if you go to the mask tool and add the mask again, and if you use brush and draw on this, CapCut told you you need to pre-process it. So you need to right click on your layer and click on the pre-process feature here, and you need to wait for process. Then disable the mask feature and enable it again and click on this quick brush. Then start draw on the background, this yellow background. Make sure don't click on the person or the subject you want to cut it. So now you can see we have a black person again, but we need to invert it. And now if I play the video, you can see we still have a little bug here. So let me invert the mask again, and we need to fix this part. So click on a quick brush, sorry, click on a quick erase this icon, and start to remove these parts. And you need to wait for process and move your playhead and see there is another issue here, and draw on it and remove it and wait for process, and continue like this to remove all the bugs in your mask, because the image passes very fast and CapCut can't track them very well, so we need to fix them. So put your playhead here when you see the issue and start to remove it. But I still see this part. Let's remove it. So as you can see, we create this video, but now we should import a color for the background. So I import this blue color, then move this layer up and put it on the top of the layer, and select both of the layer and move it down and put them on track one, then rotate it. So we can rotate it from here and type 90, then you can scale it like this. And if I play the video, you can see everything is fine here. So I can see the images and the colors in the background. Yeah. For final touch, we can make it a little like a matrix effect. So go to the effect tabs, click on a screen, then scroll a little. You can add a TV texture. So click on a DV texture and import it under the video layer, and increase the duration. So for the video layer, we can use a TV line, so apply it on it, then reduce the twist and the range, because I just want the texture on it. Then if I play the video, you can see we get this effect. You can reduce the texture and the noise for the background because it's a little too much. So I think it's done. We can use some color grading for this blue color too. So go to the adjustment and scroll a little down. You can see this vignette. You can add maybe one or two vignettes to get this shadow around. Maybe one is better. For the video layer, because I don't want to see this yellow color, we can reduce the saturation like this, or we can play with the contrast and the highlight to get a different light effect. Maybe reduce the shadow to get a little strong color. So yeah, I think it's good. We can use a different images and tell a story when you put the image under the video layer. But for this tutorial, I think it's good. So that's it. But before you go, I've put together a free editing guide for you. It's a PDF with all the tools and tips. It's totally free. You can click on the first link in the description and you can download it. And as always, stay creative. And don't forget to like and subscribe.